I'm thinking I should just make a series where I make things for my Pinterest board, like this.
You know what she said?
Just go to Goodwill, get all the materials, and make it myself instead of spending my money. And maybe learn a couple things in the process. This was actually a fun project to make. Although the material was difficult to work with and I had to pin it down, I actually got a pin stuck underneath the fabric and I ended up with multiple holes that I had to like sew around to make sure they didn't get bigger. So that's the back. And that's the front.
I showed you guys how to downsize these jeans in my last video, and now we're gonna decorate them. I wanted to do a butterfly, and you can't really do a stencil because of all the little openings, so I decided to make a stamp. I got this squishy piece of like really cheap craft foam, and now I'm cutting out my design. I got my paint going, my textile medium, hot glued my design down to a wood block to make the perfect stamp, painted it with my concoction, and then stamped each one on. You could definitely make this more clean, but I kind of like the rustic look of it when it gets close to the seams. But I did this to the whole pant. I did little tiny wings on the sides to fill in some spaces. And then this that one looked gross, so I touched it up. Ironed them all down, and this is how they look. I love this option because I always see like designer jeans with designs like this. And, you know, they're not always affordable for everybody.
Teach you how to make this top. Start by tracing around a top that you like the shape of and then cut that out. Put the right sides of the fabric together and then you're going to sew the two edges and the two straps. Once you've done that, turn the top the right way around. Then draw on where you want your contrast lines to go. I've done mine 2 inches apart from each other. You can also do the contrast stitch around the edges, that's up to you. Pinch your fabric and sew in a zigzag stitch in a straight line using your contrast colour. Once you've done that, hopefully it will look like this. Thank you for watching.
Hi, welcome to this tutorial. I'm going to show you guys how to turn a boring long sleeve shirt like this into something like this. First, you're going to crop it. Make sure you save the piece of scrap because we're going to use that at the end. Next, I use my sewing machine to take it in on the edges to make it a little tighter. I then cut off the excess, but make sure that your shirt is flipped inside out for all this. Then I flipped it to the back. I then measured halfway and cut up, but didn't go all the way up so I could save this graphic. Mark it at 1.5 inches on both sides. I can't really find my chalk right now, but I'm going to use this pencil and draw a general U shape around the back of the shirt. Okay, so I outlined and cut one half. Now I'm going to try to match it on the other side. Now that that's done, we're going to pin it. Okay, so I pinned it so that I have enough room for the strap to go all the way through, and it's okay if these overlap. Okay, so I just sewed it down. Now I'm going to make the straps. To make my straps, I'm going to use 40 inches of the scrap that I had left. Sew down 3/8 inch for the straps. Then I sewed it down and cut it out, and use your safety pin to feed it through the tunnel. And there it is.
So my girlfriend texted me saying she wanted these socks, and whatever baby wants, baby gets. So I went and got these white Nike crew socks and a bunch of tie-dye materials, and I'ma make her every color under the rainbow because that's what she deserves. Let's begin. You can see me hesitate about the color, but it turned out good. Notice how I put gloves on now because I realized that my coochie grabbers were getting stained. And you know, you gotta keep them hoes clean. So here's the finished product. She's about to look so scrumptious in these. Like a little Starburst.
Primera parte del tutorial de los tops con la misma tela, cualquier tela, ahí va el primer look, que es literalmente enrollárselo y hacer un moño atrás como a ustedes les guste. Tiene que ser una tela finita y larga, como de alguna tela vieja que tengan, alguna remera que quieran cortar y pegar. La segunda es una que a mí me encanta y sí o sí la uso con corpiño abajo por las dudas. Te la pones alrededor del cuello y la metes adentro de el pantalón o la pollera que tengas y queda súper divina, con una espalda muy 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 linda. Esta me encanta para salir con alguna pollera o algo. La tercera es lo mismo, alrededor del cuello, pero la cruzas y la atas atrás, y esta también la uso muchísimo para salir y queda increíblemente